What's going on, everyone? Welcome to the 2024 offseason for the Washington Warriors. They were not able to capture the Stanley Cup this year, sadly. The Warriors fell to the Flames after putting up a big fight in a 7-game series. 4-3 was the final score of the series. So Calgary, props to them. They did very, very well. They were able to take us down. So, we're going to be here in the offseason. We're going to decide who goes where, if we're letting anybody go, or re-signing anybody, because we have a lot of work to do in the offseason. So first things first, take a look at our contract situation here before we move on. Now, our expiring contract, we do have quite a few important people. Mateo Lopez, Cole Penn, definitely being a big two. And you look at how much cap space we have, we only have $4.4 million to work with. Now, how much did he want for an extension? He wants 8.5, and Mateo wants 10.3, which is a little bit of a problem if you can't tell. So, we might be losing one of those two players. So always keep that in mind. Our coaching staff, on the other hand, are we going to be re-signing any of them? Well, let's take a look at when they expire. Look at this. Eric Christie and Pavlik, which I really don't care about. But Christie, question is, how good has he been doing? Gallen Moko, he's a good player. I mean, you kind of want... Oh, he doesn't. He's not liking basket, but let's see. His teaching is an A. His coach influence is a B. And he is a goalie coach, so... I mean, I honestly don't think he's a bad goaltender coach. What are the influence? Okay, no, wait. Isn't there a way to look at he's a B minus, that's what he is. That's a very good goalie coach. I don't think we're getting rid of Kutsky anytime soon, but point is, let's get to ahead and get to the draft, and we can decide what we're going to do from there. So, it's going to be the draft. And the draft lottery is going to be won by the Montreal Canadiens and Detroit going from 8-2. Wow. Minnesota dropped to 3. Pittsburgh dropped to 4. Columbus dropped to 5. Boston dropped to 6. New York dropped to 7. Blah, blah, blah. You can see the rest of them there. All right, the retired players. Who is no longer playing in the NHL? Jason Spezza. Retired with over 1,000 points. That's a good first. That is a good career. Dustin Brown as well retiring. Jeff Carter. David Krejci. I'll look through them here in case there's anybody that interests you. Take a look at our goalies as well. What kind of goalies have retired? Henrik Lundqvist, baby. The King from New York. He retired on Tampa Bay. You have Ryan Miller, Jonathan Quick, Craig Anderson, Jimmy Howard. Well, my goodness. Look at how many are retiring. A lot of familiar names. And then we get down to this guy. Sammy. Okay, well, he's a pro, isn't he? Keith Yandel has become a coach for the Bruins and Mark Giordano for the Stars. That's interesting. And here we go, ready to get into the entry draft. Let's see what we're going to do here. All right, who's going first overall? The Montreal Canadiens. Erkamp. Interesting. Detroit, they're going to draft Milton. Ooh. Okay. With Crab being drafted, medium elite. Called Dingle, defenseman for Pittsburgh. And it's going to be, wow, that dropped off quick. Did Columbus get a bad pick? Or maybe, it's not that deep of a draft, is it? It's pretty... Oh, never mind, look at that. Los Angeles Kings with a steal there. At pick number 8. A medium elite left wing, 79 overall. That's good, and the first 10 picks are done. Let's go ahead and get to our pick. Ooh, look at that medium elite goalie right there. Just taken by Winnipeg, one pick before us. Interesting, okay. So who are we going to draft? So we have almost medium elite. He's probably a top 6 forward. What is the ETA? 3 years. That's not bad. What is this Esch guy? No reports on this player. He played in a possible C-minus league with 9 goals, 22 assists. That doesn't really catch my eye. Let's see if there's any gems? Any gems hidden around? Ooh! At number 75. Look at this guy. We're gonna pin him real quick. Gotta keep my eye on him. Let's go ahead and... Oh, look at this. Phil Vigetti, if you know, XTech fan. Okay. Ooh, wow. A medium league goalie at number 72. We're going to take this guy right now because I want to get that gem as well. We're taking this goalie. Medium league goalie, give me that. 47 overall, decent. There he is, Holton. Let's take him. What is this going to be? A gem. He is a 64 low top pick. That's not bad. Center powerful. That could be something. And to the end of the draft, that is going to do it. Nice little draft. I mean, we didn't get anything in particular. It's not expected. I mean, we didn't make the finals last year, so you know what? That's okay. We're going to go to the re-sign phase and see what we can do here. Let's go ahead and re-sign our goalie coach here. We definitely want Christie back. Give him a nice little contract there as a NHL goalie coach. We're going to raise it up a little bit because I feel like he's probably not going to want it. So we'll give him 7.5 to be the goalie coach for 3 years. Pavlik, on the other hand, make him an AHL goalie coach. Give him that. I think he'll be fine with that. Now for our NHL contract, what are we going to do in this situation? We have a little bit of trouble right here on our hand. But we did have we suddenly have $18 million in cap space. Maybe we're not. Let's see what Mateo Lopez wants for us. He still wants $10.5 million. Yikes. Cole Penn, on the other hand, I mean, that's not a bad deal. I think we're going to qualify them both as RFA. I mean, I kind of wanted to. They both want extensions. So you want, maybe I can get lucky out of this and just sign Lopez for $10 million. That's a lot of money. But I mean, Lopez is such a big part. You know what? Do that. Maybe he'll take that. We're going to qualify Cole Penn as an RFA, or do we want to sign him? I don't know. Let's see what else we have. So, Ramo, he is gone. We don't need you. Sharp, we don't need you. Harris, we don't need you. It's a random Backlund guy. Get out of here. Sterling, we'll sign him for the AHL. We also have Gesser here. Sign him for the AHL. We have Farabee here. Sign him for the AHL as well. We have Evans here, another AHL player. We can just get in there. We have Michael McLeod. I don't think we're going to sign this guy. We really do not need him. So we're just going to let him go, whatever. You have Dylan Gauthier here as well. Could be for the AHL, but we're not going to keep him there. We're going to let him go as well. Brandon Crable, 1.3. And then we have Gene Crable, 1.8. We're going to qualify them both at RFA. You know what? Brandon Crable does not want to be re-signed, so we're going to qualify her with RFA. But June does, then we're going to go ahead and take the contract. We're going to go 1.4 for 3 years, let's say. 1.5 for 3 years. 1.55 for 3 years. I think that's a good deal. Let's see if they accept Lopez and Crable. Hopefully, Christie said no. Interesting. And, alright, Pavlik, he said yes. AHL goalie coach is coming back. Jake Evans. Oh, did I give him an extension? Oops. I did not mean to. June Crable said no, and Mateo Lopez said yes. Farabee, he said yes. Oh yeah, we were supposed to get Evans, that's right. Sterling said yes, Gitter said yes. Alright, let's go ahead and get Jake Evans back. We definitely want to re-sign him just because he's an AHL player. Let's go, you know what? Maybe not. Jake Evans, we're going to let him go. He's 20 years old, we don't want to keep him in the AHL. Let's get him go. Let's be nice. But here we go with this contract. Brenda Crable said no to that contract. So we're going to go 3 years at 1.65. Hopefully she'll accept that. Let's see. June Crable said no. Okay. Well, she really wants a one-year contract, so let's go ahead and do that. 1 year at 1.6. Do you accept that? No. Apparently not. All right. Let's just give her what she wants then. 1.8 for 1 year. June Crable's coming back. There we go. Now, Cole Penn wants 8. Oh, we have 18.3. Okay, wait. Let's take a look at our goalie situation, too. We can't forget that. Okay. Well, we can. Vahalainen can go. We don't need these players. Yeah, everybody can just get on out of here, except for Kantor. I want to keep Kantor, obviously. He's 76, he's 76 medium elite, 20 years old. That is a gem of a goaltender. We're not letting him go. But all expiring, Brenda Crable's on that. Cole Penn, 8.3. Would he take that? 8.3 for 7 years? That's a very, very risky contract. You know, we're going to qualify with RFA. We're gonna make the risky play. We're going to qualify him. That's what we're going to do. For our coaching staff, on the other hand, what do we want to do with Christie? We do want to re-sign him, but we're going to have to give him quite a bit of money. So NHL goalie coach, let's just rack up the money to like 800,000. Let's go with that. Or 900,000. Whatever it is. I don't know what it is. 900,000, I believe. But simulate the day. Kantor says yes. Good. There's a goalie coming back. We needed that. And Christie says no. Wow. Okay, Christie. I guess we're not getting that goalie coach back. That kind of sucked. All right, well, let's whatever then. Let's see if we can get a goalie coach in here. Let's find the highest one. There's Christie still there. I want Christie back. So you know what? We're just gonna rack up the money there, like that. And we're gonna go for a little something like this. 1.12 for 3 years. Come on, Christie. That's like an obvious deal. You know you want to take that. Let's be honest. Come on. Anybody would be taking that. But all right. Now we go into free agency. Now, take a look at our team. Okay, we have a lot of players that we have, and most of them that we kind of don't need, but here we go. Look at that. I mean, look at what we got here. Nugent Hopkins was on his last year. We might be trading Nugent Hopkins just because, I mean, look at all these players we have, man. For centers, I mean, we have plenty that are ready to play. Look at Shane Wright ready to go. left wingers, we got plenty of left wingers, right wingers, we got three, we can send one of the centers in there for defensemen. I mean, we have enough defensemen to go, we don't need Cole Penn, but I would like to have Cole Penn. Morty just doesn't have to play, we can have a monstrous defense. Adrian MT and Mel Young are still on a really good contract for a couple of years. That's a good thing to see. Jack Dreamer will be, his contract will be expiring next year, but you know what? We will deal with that when the time comes, we don't need to worry about that now. We definitely have enough players to get ourselves to go. So Cole Penn, I might only be signing him for 1 year if we do get him back, that is the thing. Let's take a look, where's Cole Penn? There he is. He wants more money now, which is the thing. So you know what? I don't know if Cole Penn's going to be coming back or not. He is a defenseman, which is very important to have. But I just don't know if we can bring him back. But let's look at here. Anybody interesting here? Got a bunch of crazy players. Alright. And look at that Patrice Bergeron there too. But you know what? We're going to let this go by a little bit. We're going to see if Cole Penn is going to get any offer sheets. And we're going to try to re-sign him. We're definitely going to try. But it's going to be hard. And Christy finally accepts. Thank you, Christy. Good lord. And there's Brenda Crable. 1.5. I mean, we really don't need Brenda Crable, so... Wait, what did this match offer? You will not receive any compensation. I don't want to. I don't want to. I mean, I'm good with letting Brenda Crable go. So this reminds me of 6-8, I guess. I'd rather let Brenda Crable go. I mean, we don't need Brenda. She's ready to go to another team. And she has a good enough overall to play on another team, so I'm not going to keep her. But yeah, just continue. I mean, it's just kind of taking her, kind of taking that off. But yeah, continue. You can have her, Dallas. Oh, never mind. Oh boy, look at that. 4 first round picks by the Winnipeg Jets. Hold on 1 second. That is an interesting one. Winnipeg is willing to pay that much. I do want to keep Cole Penn, but my goodness. Where did the Winnipeg Jets end up last season? Where did they end up? Let's take a look. All the way down at the bottom of the league. Where's Winnipeg? Winnipeg was... Oh, they made the play. Oh no. I don't want to do that. Oh no. I don't know if I want to take that. I mean, Winnipeg is... Oh no. Okay. Let's take a look at their lines. I guess. I need to see what they have on their team for... What does Winnipeg got? Because this is about to be really scary if they... Oh god, let's see. For center, they have Mark Scheifele. Yeah, they got a pretty good team there in Winnipeg. They're lacking a couple pieces, but I think it's good enough to get them through. Yeah, with Cole Penn adding to the roster, they're going to be pretty good. They got Peterson as well. They're definitely looking like a semi-playoff team, which I don't want. I think we're going to have to clear up a little bit of cap space. So, I think everybody kind of knows what that means. Ladies and gentlemen, I think it's time to say goodbye to a beloved Washington Warriors player. Nobody really wants this to happen, but it kind of needs to happen in order to get Cole Penn back. It's Nugent Hopkins, 31 years old, 85 overall, $7.7 million to clear up that cap space for Cole Penn. We kind of have to get rid of Nugent Hopkins at this point. We need to find somebody. How about the New Jersey Devils? A third and a fourth for Nugent Hopkins. Come on, New Jersey. Trade accepted. Nugent Hopkins is gone. We have the cap space to sign Cole Penn now, which is exactly what we kind of needed to do. We didn't need Nugent Hopkins, sadly. I wanted to bring him back. I didn't want to get rid of Nugent Hopkins, but it was the smart thing to do and the right thing to do. So Ryan Nugent Hopkins, thank you for your service. I don't know, but we're going to match you all for Cole Penn. Come back to Washington, my friend. You're not going anywhere. And there we go. We're going to go ahead and edit our lines here. We got an interesting setup this season. So we want... Okay. I think we want this first line to be the same, but it's not giving us that plus anymore, which is interesting. But look at the lineups that we have going here. If Shane Wright ready to play in the NHL, that's interesting. I'm good with Shane Wright playing. This line is a little strange. How are we going to get this one done? What if we need that? Nope. John Freaky playing up here works. I'm not sure if I want to play Freaky there, though. Gene Crable, we have Vincent Echo. We have a lot of options. I'm looking for some chemistry here, but it doesn't look like we're getting much chemistry. It's going to be a weird year for chemistry, that's for sure, but I think we have a good enough team to kind of substitute for that chemistry. So, you know what? Let's see who we got. Brad, Morty, and Paul Mysterious, that's okay. We have Jack Dreamer and Cole Penn on the first line. Can we get any chemistry better with that? We can get a +3, but a -3. We don't want that. We'd like to avoid that. Okay. Oh, we have Mel Young and Adrian MT, and then we have... Okay. I mean, I'm okay with this. Carly Pham and Kadex Dragon, this is a good defensive core. good offensive core. I mean, the lowest overall we have on our team is 84 right now, right? Yeah, that's very good. Goaltender-wise, yeah, we like freaking Max Martin still in that. Special team, this is where it comes into play. I think we want Zanny to be playing center. Do we want... Where's the tail? Why is Hero down? Hero needs to be playing up there. What happens if we move Mateo? Ooh, look at that. A +3 if we move Mateo there. Alright, I'm keeping that +3. We want Robbie Zanny to be playing there with Yokozu and Mothin? Do we want Yokozu? Well, we want to switch them around if we're going to do that. But sadly, we can do that. There we go. That's a better combination. I'm okay with that. Vincent Echo, but we don't want Billy Bowl. We're gonna want. Do we have Adrian Antti? We have Drafting. We have Vincent Echo. Karthik Pham, an offensive defenseman. I didn't do much. Was there a +1 on this line before? I don't remember. I don't think so. Maybe there was. I don't know anymore. Let's go to the 4-man power play. Anything interesting that we can do here for this team? We got a -2 there. Which isn't a worst thing in the world, but then again, you don't necessarily want that. We want Hero playing there, we want Dream playing there, Yokozu playing defense is whatever. I think we're good with that right there, that's fine. Penalty kill wise, ooh, we got a -3 there, that is not something we want to see. How are we going to fix it? We can move that for a -2. Karthik Pham, I don't think Karthik Pham is a good fit for that. What if we bring in Mel Young? That helps. Colpen does not like playing there, though. He doesn't like playing a penalty kill. We'll see that, Colpen. You're literally a defensive defenseman. I do not care. Oh, I think that's good for the penalty kill. Oh, we could. Here we go. Let's do that. Perfect. No minuses. Well, here we have a -3 and a 3-man penalty kill. There's not too many of those, but when there is, we're probably going to get scored on it, which is what we don't want. So, doesn't look like there's much we can do. We're just going to leave it. Fine. Exit right here. I'm okay with that. 4-4 continued. We have 3-on-3 here. I'm good with what I see. Extra attacker is good. Shootout. Okay, looking good. And then, alright. So, look at that. I guess the top 5 highest overalls on offense. We have Hero at number 1, Xanadu at number 2, Lopez and Gal tied, and then number 3, Emily. Or, sorry, number 5, Emily. And then for defense, Colpen, Jack Beamer, and of course, Adrian MT. Very good. Very good. I'm proud of that. So, that is going to do it for our lineup. Our captains, on the other hand, of course, we have Hero as the captain, Lopez as the alternate captain, and Jack Dreamer as the other alternate. I think I am good with that. All right, we are now here at the regular season. Let's advance to the first game of the season. Who do we have? Oh, what was our record, is a better way to put it. Okay, we were 2 wins, 3 wins, 4 wins, 5 wins, and we were 5-0-2 in the preseason. That's pretty good. So, of course, we're going to go to the first game of the season here against the New York Raiders. We are starting the season, which is always good. Hopefully, we get a good start here. 1-on-1, it's Zachary Gell on the power play. Panera, I'm going to tie it. Oh, 4-3 Rangers. This is a crazy game, and the Rangers beat a 6-3 in our first game of the season. That's not too good. Not what I like to see. Of course, that's only one game out of a whole season, so let's see if there's any important games. Oh, well, look at that. The Calgary Flames right there. We played right at the beginning of the season twice. And Colorado, who also did very well this season. Let's see. 9-2 win. Well, that is quite a victory. Let's go against the Calgary Flames. What are we going to do? Are we going to get the win? 0-0. 5-0. Talk about revenge. My goodness. And a 7-0 win. Take that, Calgary. With the Calgary Flames here yet again. Second time. The only time we're going to play them in the season. 2-1. And we win the season series with Calgary. Vincent Echo with the game-winning goal on the power play. And they have Thatcher Demko in the net. Did they get rid of Riddich? If they did, that's Stephen. Why would you get rid of it? He literally had the best playoff of his career. And here we are at the Wildcats game. We're having a pretty good start to the year. 13-3-1. We are first in our division. Let's see if we can keep that against the Wildcats here. I believe they are second, of course, as usual. It's Virginia. See what we do against them. First period, 4-2. My goodness, high scoring. Second period, 6-3. And there we go. 6-3 win against the Virginia Wildcats. Oh my goodness, is that a 10-4 win? It was a 10-4 win against the Islanders. 11-4 against the Canadiens. What in the world is... Okay, Washington popping off. Hello. 8-3 against the Los Angeles Kings after a 4-3 loss to the Blues. That's one way to bounce back. My goodness. We scored some pretty high scoring games. I don't even think I had the scoring engine up to high. I'm pretty sure it's just on medium. That is crazy. The Warriors have some pretty good offense now, don't they? We played a Dallas Stars 2 years ago in the finals and beat them for a second straight Stanley Cup. And we got a 5-0 win against them there. And we have another one coming up too. Not going to simulate it, but we're going to simulate these 2 Wildcats games because, well, they are rivals. We got to do it. It's just what we got to do. Can't avoid it. Here we go. In Virginia again, 3-1. Tickets at 2 and 9-4. Lopez with 2 goals. Did he have a hat trick? They had to do a 2 goals as well. Oh, no, he didn't. Never mind. All right, Virginia. We are 3-0 in the season 2. That 30-10-3. We are 34-7-1, I believe that said. 3-1 win. Okay. Well, we're definitely not 1. And a 5-4 victory. Wow, they almost tied it, but we were able to get it back just in time. We are 35-7-1. So we do have 1 overtime loss. Okay, interesting. 9-1 win. Do we want to go into the trade deadline? I don't think so. My goodness, 9-1 win against the Oilers. We're gonna go past the trade deadline because I really am not looking to make any trades. So I'm not even gonna worry about that. But let's see if there's any big moves. Take a look. Hopefully the notification comes up. Oh, another notification. Whoa. Okay, 8-1 win against the Sharks. 65 against the. All right, the Florida Panthers. Anything interesting? A couple pick trades. Michael Shaw. Connor Murphy. Then Frederick Anderson went to the Bruins. Okay, then. It's done. Doesn't look like there's any huge thing. Scott Mayfield, Reno, Sam Bennett, Michael McLeod. Oh, Roy. Wait, oh, I forgot he got drafted to a different team. That's interesting. Okay. What else? Brian Rust went to the Flyers. Nikita Zadorov. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's any blockbusters. Yeah, Jack Roth. I was like, okay, no blockbusters, but a decent trade deadline, I guess. Whatever. Let's go ahead and get to the end of the year. We're going to the final 5 game. First up against the Minnesota Wild. Let's get there. 7-1 win against the LA Kings. That's what I like to see. Now, here we are. The final 5 game of the season. First up against the Minnesota Wild. Let's see how we do. We are looking to go for 65 wins. That is 60-14-3. All right, let's see how we do. 1-0 to Jacozu. 4-3 and takes a 3 win. Jack Dreamer and Adrian Empty with the game-winning goals. And our final game of the season against the New York Islanders are not a very good team, so let's hope we can put them away pretty easily here. 1-0 Xanadu, 2-0 there's Cole Penn, and 3-0 Robbie Xanadu again. That is going to do it on the power play. We are finishing the season 64-15-3, 131 points. That is 100% a President Trophy victory. You'll love to see it. And our round one opponent is going to be against the Pittsburgh Penguins. Wow, that is interesting. Nobody likes it. Oh, I shouldn't say that. Anyway, so let's take a look at how we did in the season. Let's see who's on top, what's going on. Zachary Gell on top with 111, Hero with 108. Most goals to the team, of course, goes to Hero. Most assists goes to Gell, and of course, my point, Gell again. So look at that. We actually, oh, Emily Moss at number 4 in points. Okay, 63 assists. Good lord. And Xanadu with 74, Dreamer with 60, 50. Okay, my goodness, look at that point on the. Who did the worst? X-Dragon only had the worst person on the team at 16 points. That's actually really good. That is really good. How's our plus minus doing? Not a single person was on a minus. Would you look at that? Oh my goodness. Good rest shooting percentage. Hero with 19.5. Not surprising. Who else? Who had the most hit? I'd imagine Jack Dreamer? No. He's not even on the list. Jack Dreamer had 105. The most hit. Oh, sorry, he didn't have 105, he had a 73. He had 73. And the most went to Xanadu with 170. Okay, Xanadu putting on the body. Most block shots by Dreamer, most giveaways by Jack, most takeaways by Mateo, most fights. Jack with 26, that's not surprising. 26-4. Dreamer the goon, but alright. Washington Warriors with a very good season. Especially for the players. Let's see how we did team-wise. Washington 131 points, 64-15-3, 59 regulation plus overtime wins. Goals for is 351. The power play percentage, the point percentage was 79%. The goals for game was 4.28. You know, let's look at the whole league, see where we compare. Yeah, we definitely had looking like the most out of every team. Yeah, the most goals against. We are number 2. Barely below. Oh my goodness, Chicago Blackhawks almost tied us there. Goals against per game. And we are at number 2. Power play goals. We have 96. Wow. Compared to the 71 Panthers, our power play definitely going to work. Total power plays are number 3. Power play percentage were on top. Shorthanded goals against. You know what? I don't think it really matters about that. Power play goals against. Doesn't really matter about that. Time shorthanded. Where are we? We're not there. That's good. Penalty kill percentage, we are number 3 with 85%. That's pretty good. Shorthanded gold 4. We rank right there. 5 shorthanded gold. Wow. Oh my goodness, the Virginia Wildcats. Our home record is the best. Away record in the second match, okay. In our last 10 games, we finished off the season pretty strong. Second as well, tied with the Avalanche. Okay, so we got some pretty good teams. That's a pretty good season there for the Washington Warriors. Okay, okay. And playoff tree, let's take a look at what we got. With the Wildcats taking on the Rangers, we're taking on the Penguins, Tampa versus Toronto, Florida versus the Flyers. Then over there we have Chicago and Dallas, Calgary and Arizona. Oh, sorry, Colorado and Arizona, Calgary and Vegas, and San Jose and Winnipeg. Interesting playoff. But that is going to do it for the season, and that is going to do it for the video. I don't think there's much else we need to show off. We're just kind of going to have to get to the playoff. We'll take one more look at our lineup here, see if anybody went up or down in overall. You know what? I went to the wrong thing. I went to view lines, not edit lines. My bad. Let's take a look at what we got. 92 all on the board, 93. Malton still at 90. Martinez still 89. Doesn't look like anybody went up or down in overall by the looks of it. So you know what? That's okay. That's good. I'm proud of that. The Washington is finishing off the season number one. That's a President's Trophy win for your Washington Warriors. And the Penguins are going to be our round one opponent. So, thank you everybody for stopping by. Stay humble with the Warriors. We will catch you in the playoffs with the Pittsburgh Penguins in 2025. Peace out.